Hello, and good morning, Nipher. I'm Jackson.
And I'm Jacob. Today is Wednesday, October 24th.
Today's Red Ribbon theme celebrates our uniqueness. We can't wait to see how you dressed up for Wacky Wednesday.
Thursday's theme will be living drug-free is no sweat, so dress in your favorite pair of sweatpants.
Friday will be team day, so wear your favorite jersey, sweatshirt, and or hat.
In honor of Red Ribbon Week, we looked into how drugs are affecting the United States.
Sam takes us to the opioid crisis that is becoming an increasing concern in St. Louis and beyond.
Red Ribbon Week is an alcohol, tobacco, and other drug and violence prevention awareness campaign. To help raise awareness, I researched about the Missouri opioid epidemic. Opioids were originally a pain reliever pill prescribed by doctors. People started misusing them, and it shows how dangerous these drugs can be. Heroin is a type of opioid. It is illegal, but many people find ways to get it anyway. It can be a white or brown powder or a black tar-like substance. In short term, it and other opioids can cause feelings of calmness, sleepiness, and confusion, slow or stopped breathing, and nausea. In the long term, you can get addicted, have lung infections, or muscle pain. Opioids are a big issue, especially in the Midwest and Missouri. Between 1999 and 2015, Missouri experienced a 273% increase in the number of overdose deaths, with 65% of those being the cause of opioids. From 2006 to 2015, there was a 538% increase in babies, infants, born addicted to drugs. This graph shows that the majority of opioid overdose deaths were from the white, non-Hispanic people in the U.S. These drugs are a real issue. If you know someone who may be addicted or even thinking of trying out heroin or any sort of illegal drugs, tell an adult you trust and or contact authorities as soon as possible.
There are a lot of community groups trying to make sure that the opioid crisis will not continue to get worse.
We can all do our part by choosing to be drug-free and finding help for friends and family members who need it.
Remember to submit those turkey trot designs to Mrs. Shriver by November 1st.
Maybe your design could be the one on our shirts.
Now is the time to get working on your door decorations.
Make sure your contact gets in on the competition. Judging will take place on October 31st.
Bonus points for incorporating Halloween and the theme Life is a Journey, Travel Drug Free.
One of the new clubs is the D20 Adventure Club.
Miranda went to go see what the adventure was all about.
Want to know more about the D20 Club? Well, now you can. I interviewed Mr. Scimone about his club.
Hello, you are in charge of D20, right?
Yep.
So I have three questions for you. What do you do at D20?
So at the D20 Club, we play Dungeons and Dragons. Mm-hmm. And we get together, and if you've never played Dungeons & Dragons before, it's a game that uses a lot of imagination combined with chance.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of a fantasy game where you make up different scenarios, and you can fight monsters or you can go through mazes. And it's a really fun game if you like to hang out with other people and interact and use your imagination.
All right, thank you. There's another question. What kind of games do you play besides Dungeons and Dragons?
At the D20 Club?
Yes.
So that's all we're playing right now. Whenever I started the D20 Club, I thought maybe we would play some other games, but after we had the first meeting, it became pretty clear that people just wanted to play Dungeons and Dragons.
All right, last question. Why did you make this club?
So I play Dungeons and Dragons with some friends, and last year I mentioned this to a student, and the student said, oh, we should start a club here. And at the time, I wasn't really ready to, but that student ended up telling their friends who also played Dungeons and Dragons. And before I know it, I had a lot of sixth graders coming to me and saying, we want to start a Dungeons and Dragons club, would you be the sponsor? And so I said, I needed a year. So that led us to this year. So really the answer to your question is I had a lot of students that wanted the club to get started.
Mm-hmm.
Now we have about 25 people that came to the last meeting. Each meeting we've had more and more people. So the games are starting to get kind of big, but we've had a lot of fun. It's good that we have a lot of people because that means you know, everybody's enjoying it.
Thank you very much.
Mm-hmm. Well, if you would like to check it out, it meets next Thursday.
The after-school activities today are Power Hour in 106 South,
Robotics in Library Lab 1 with Mr. Baker,
Art Cafe in the Art Room with Dr. Holly,
and Coding Club with Mr. Scimone in Library Lab 3.
Just a reminder to take a look at the new books in the library.
You guys, it's Ms. Skinder. We have over 100 new books in the library. I'm going to tell you about a couple of them. This one's fantastic, Piecing Me Together. We all have difficulties finding our identity. This is a great book about a girl just doing that. Look at this, Amal Unbound. Best cover ever. This girl is in Pakistan. They won't let her get an education. It's about her struggle to succeed. Okay, how many people? You have asked me about the sequel to The War That Saved My Life. Here it is, guys. I got two copies. The War I Finally Won. Come get it. Everybody's a huge fan of this author, Mary Downing Hahn. If you're brave, you can try her new scary book, One for the Sorrow. I've had about six people asking for Keeper of Lost Cities, whole series. We've got it now. Oh, and all my anime fans, you've been asking for the next ones in Full Metal Alchemist. We got it, plus about seven more anime books. You're gonna love them. And also, How Did Mary Shelley Actually Come to Write Frankenstein? Mary's Monster. Come check it out. If you look on Destiny Quest, you can see the full list of all the new additions. So I'll see you soon. Thanks, Nipher. Keep reading.
Well, that's all, folks.
Thanks for watching.
And remember,
you belong at Nipher.